Some people say that Tallulah Riley manipulated and mistreated Elon Musk. Well, I agree. So in this video, we are going to review the relationship between Elon Musk and Tallulah Riley, and we will zero in on the techniques and behavior they make for poor and toxic relationships. The goal is to help you recognize manipulative and toxic behavior so that you can better assess characters and find better partners. So let's start.
1. She devalues his contribution. Devaluing is a common technique of social manipulation. Look at Tallulah Riley doing it in this video.
I don't know how he handles the stress. I mean, if I was him, I'd have died of a heart attack. You would not wish that kind of pain on your worst enemy.
Tallulah says that their life with Elon Musk is extremely stressful and worse than a heart attack. I will personally guess that a billionaire can get all the help he wants with the kids and that she can live as a queen. But hey, you never know. It might even be stressful. The point is, why would you go so extreme, and why on television? Because the more she can officialize that he's taking from her, the more she can take and control the relationship. This is a form of social exchange manipulation. In social exchange theory, we all have a natural inclination to keep relationships balanced in terms of giving and taking. When she frames Elon Musk as taking so much value from her life, she makes him feel guilty and puts him in the position of having to make up for it. Making up for it how? By giving more and never ask for anything. So she can take and never give anything. That's the definition of the relationship prize. Needless to say, this is a nasty power move. If you see it from your partner or from anybody in general, treat it as a huge red flag.
2. She recruits others to devalue him. Recruiting others is a relatively common technique in persuasion and manipulation. Instead of just saying what you think and feel, some people recruit others or imaginary others to strengthen their message. For example, people might say, everyone does it, or every sensible person thinks this way.
Is that normal?
Listen to Tallulah using this technique.
My parents are traumatized by this whole experience.
Tallulah uses this technique by recruiting her parents. By saying that they are traumatized by this whole experience, she indirectly says that Elon Musk isn't only ruining her, but he is also ruining her parents' life. Elon Musk could play the same game back on her, for example, by saying, oh, strange, everyone I know will be happy to see their daughters married to a billionaire. But hey, who knows, maybe your parents are different and they will be happier if you're married to a drug addict. 3. She devalues him. As much as she devalues his contribution, she also devalues him personally. Listen up and see if you can spot the devaluation.
Elon proposed really quickly. The idea of being swept off your feet is appealing, and I'd probably have said yes to anyone that seemed half sensible if they proposed after 10 days, just because it's kind of an interesting thing to do.
It's when she says, I would have said yes to anyone. That's the equivalent of saying that he's not special to her in any way. This says a lot about how much she cares about him or the relationship, in my opinion. In good relationships, people build each other up, and Tallulah here is doing the exact opposite. She's tearing him down. 4. She uses threats of abandonment. Breakup threats are some of the most obvious, most aggressive tools of control and manipulation. See Tallulah doing it here.
Although there's been so many times that, right, I'm getting on a plane to England and I'm never gonna see you again.
Tallulah is shrewd enough not to go too direct with the threat here, but when she jokes that she might take a plane and never see him again, she indirectly says that she might leave at the drop of a hat. Very nasty power move. Check out the article on how to handle relationship threats. 5. She one-ups him. One-upping is similar to devaluing, but with a twist. Such as, while she devalues him, she also frames herself as superior. Look at this video.
Some sort of hapless engineer that had wandered into a London club, and he just looked so forlorn. He was sort of just sat in a corner on his BlackBerry, and he looked really out of place and sad. I was, you know, trying to be very sweet to him and sort of humouring him, going, oh yes, when he was going, this is my rocket. And you
know. She frames him as a dork who was lost and insecure, while she appears sociable, worldly, and, well, superior. Poor and confrontational relationships are a constant string of one-ups. You want to avoid it, absolutely. But even more, you want to avoid being one-upped and doing nothing about it. Because that sends the message that your partner can be as rude as she wants, and you are not going to do anything about it.
of silence.
6. Prize Power Moves. Look at this video of Tallulah basking in the limelight while he waits for her. In my opinion, it's a sign of not respecting someone to let him wait for so long. In this case, it's also an example of an I'm the prize power move. Why? Because the photographer are asking for Tallulah's picture, not of Elon Musk. So the longer she remains in the limelight with people calling her name, the more she expands on the thread of her being the real prize of the relationship. And the longer Elon Musk waits, the more he expands the thread that he is the less valuable and less powerful part in the relationship. Tallulah Riley doesn't care. Ultimately, we only have a few videos to judge from, but judging from these videos, we can say that this is not how a supportive or caring woman behaves. In my opinion, she doesn't even feel emotionally close to him. Take this scene, for example.
Right, I'm getting on a plane to England and I'm never gonna see you again.
Really?
No. No, not really.
If she really wanted to take the joke back, build him back up, and mend the relationship, she would have gotten physically close to him when she said no really. Instead, she laughs at him and remains cold and distant. Is Elon Musk clueless? I made a previous video on Elon Musk, and some fans didn't like it. Some commenters say that Elon Musk is a smart guy and that he chose not to confront or deal with Tallulah's games. Look, I don't know that. I'm not in his head, you are also not in his head, so we cannot say for sure. Certainly, it's within the realm of possibility that Elon Musk understood the manipulation in games and he chose to let them slip. Personally, though, I don't think that's the case. To me, it's simple logic. If you understand you are being mistreated, manipulated, and publicly humiliated, then why would you willingly choose not to do anything about it when you can do something about it? That's the whole point. Elon Musk probably didn't even see those dynamics. I don't think it's offensive to suggest that Elon Musk doesn't understand power dynamics and manipulation. The guy is a genius, a legend, a billionaire, and you know, you cannot be great at everything. And that's also not necessary to say that Elon Musk is a naive victim with no aggression in him. He has been rumored to pressure his wife to dye their hair blonde, and he has been rumored to have once said, "I am the alpha male here." Of course, that sounds a bit ridiculous to me, because saying that you are the alpha male doesn't make you the alpha. If anything, it makes you less of an alpha. Especially so if you don't even know how to enforce fair boundaries of basic respect.
Really?
So where does that lead us? Well, for one, if you want to become a billionaire entrepreneur, and you want to acquire a higher level of power awareness so that you can attract and maintain higher quality mates within higher quality relationships, then Power University is for you. Thank you for listening. Arrivederci and big hug. Ciao, ciao.